So, after studying what the population growth models, the two types of population growth models we have studied, one is the exponential growth model and the other one is what? The logistic growth model, right? See, in both of these cases, we have come across one thing in common, that is the availability of the resources, right? So, even though the resources are available to the maximum extent, organisms also, the population size or population growth of the particular population also depends upon the strategy of reproduction adapted by the particular organism. Andre, so no matter how much the resources are available, so yeshte resources available idru kuda population growth aguvantaddu, it also depends upon one more factor, yenu ರೀಪ್ರೊಡಕ್ಷನ್ ಯಾವ ರೀತಿ ಆಗ್ತಾ ಇದೆ, ವೆದರ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಫಾಲೋಯಿಂಗ್ ದ ಅಸೆಕ್ಷುಯಲ್ ಮೋಡ್ ಆಫ್ ರೀಪ್ರೊಡಕ್ಷನ್ ಆರ್ ಸೆಕ್ಷುಯಲ್ ಮೋಡ್ ಆಫ್ ರೀಪ್ರೊಡಕ್ಷನ್, ರೈಟ್? ಸೊ ಅದ್ರದ್ದು ಲೈಫ್ ಹಿಸ್ಟ್ರಿ ಹೇಗಿದೆ, ಸೊ ಅಸೆಕ್ಷುಯಲ್ ಮೋಡ್ ಅಥವಾ ಸೆಕ್ಷುಯಲ್ ಮೋಡ್ ಇತ್ತು ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದರೆ ನಂಬರ್ ಆಫ್ ಇಂಡಿವಿಜುವಲ್ಸ್ ಎಷ್ಟು ಬರ್ತಾ ಇದೆ, ದೊಡ್ಡದು ಒಂದೇ ಬರ್ತಾ ಇದೆಯಾ ಅಥವಾ ಸಣ್ಣ ಸಣ್ಣದು ತುಂಬ ಬರ್ತಾ ಇದೆಯಾ, ಸೊ ಆಲ್ ದೀಸ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಮ್ಯಾಟರಿಂಗ್. ಸೊ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ವಾಟ್ ವಿ ಸ್ಟಡಿ ಹಿಯರ್ ಅಂಡರ್ ದ ಹೆಡಿಂಗ್ ಲೈಫ್ ಹಿಸ್ಟ್ರಿ ವೇರಿಯೇಷನ್ಸ್, ಹೌ ದ ಪಾಪ್ಯುಲೇಷನ್ ವಿಲ್ ವೇರಿ or population growth is affected because of the life history of these organisms. So population, so Darwin, so here we talk about, see, always all populations of any species, they always tend to evolve to the maximum extent of their evolution, to the peak of their evolution. A peak of evolution ante helidre enu ante helidre, reaching to the most reliable, the most what, efficient mode of reproduction. ಯಾವುದೇ ಆರ್ಗಾನಿಸಮ್ ಆದರೂ ಕೂಡ ಇಟ್ ಶುಡ್ ಬಿ ಏಬಲ್ ಟು ಅಡಾಪ್ಟ್ ಟು ದ ಮೋಸ್ಟ್ ಎಫಿಷಿಯಂಟ್ ಮೋಡ್ ಆಫ್ ರೀಪ್ರೊಡಕ್ಷನ್. ಇಟ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಬಿ ಅಸೆಕ್ಷುಯಲ್, ಇಟ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಬಿ ಸೆಕ್ಷುಯಲ್, ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದಟ್ ಕೈಂಡ್ ಆಫ್ ಫಿಟ್ನೆಸ್, ದಟ್ ಕೈಂಡ್ ಆಫ್ ರೀಪ್ರೊಡಕ್ಟಿವ್ ಫಿಟ್ನೆಸ್ ಈಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ಡಾರ್ವಿನಿಯನ್ ಫಿಟ್ನೆಸ್ ಅಂತ ಕರಿತೇವೆ. ಸೊ ಡಾರ್ವಿನಿಯನ್ ಫಿಟ್ನೆಸ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ, ಸೊ ಎಸ್ಪೆಷಲಿ ವೆನ್ ವಿ ಸೇ ಡಾರ್ವಿನಿಯನ್ ಫಿಟ್ನೆಸ್ ಆರ್ ರೀಪ್ರೊಡಕ್ಟಿವ್ ಫಿಟ್ನೆಸ್ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದರೆ, ಆಬ್ವಿಯಸ್ಲಿ ಫಾರ್ ದಟ್ ಪಾಪ್ಯುಲೇಷನ್ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ ಆಫ್ ಆರ್ ಈಸ್ ಆಲ್ವೇಸ್ ಹೈ, highest R value. Yakandre, when the population is following the most efficient mode of reproduction, that means that it must be able to produce a good number of individuals as the offspring. That means population size keeps on growing no matter what, because they have adapted to the most efficient mode of reproduction. The birth rate is always higher than compared to the death rate. That is what is called as Darwinian fitness or reproductive fitness. This can be one mark important question. No disappoint, right? So what are those reproductive strategies are in order to achieve the Darwinian fitness or reproductive fitness? Which are the different types of reproductive strategies are followed by the different living organisms? And that is what we study as life history. Some organisms breed only once in their lifetime, maybe animals or plants. Like example, so Pacific salmon fish anta, Pacific salmon fish, it will breed only once in its lifetime. Similarly, you have learned the other two examples of the plants, like which one? Neel Kuranji, Strobilanthus kuntiana, if you remember from the chapter 1 of the second year, right? And also the bamboo, Strobilanthus kuntiana will produce the flowers once in 14 years and it will end life. That is the end of the life cycle of the plant. Similarly, bamboo also, so they will produce different species of bamboos, they produce flowers, maybe from their range, very species galali, maybe it may be ranging from 50 to 100 years. So ashtu period nalli they will produce the flowers once the breeding season is over and a plant will die. So other example, some others breed many times during their lifetime. ಲೈಫ್ ಸೈಕಲ್ನಲ್ಲಿ ಒಂದಲ್ಲ ಹಲವಾರು ಸಲ ಬ್ರೀಡ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಹೋಗುತ್ತೆ. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್, ಮೋಸ್ಟ್ ಬರ್ಡ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಮ್ಯಾಮಲ್ಸ್, ಎಸ್ಪೆಷಲಿ ಮ್ಯಾಮಲ್ಸಲ್ಲಿ ನಾವು ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಲರ್ನ್ಟ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ದ ವಾಟ್ ಟೂ ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್ ಟೈಪ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಸೈಕಲ್ಸ್, ರೈಟ್? ಈಸ್ಟರ್ ಸೈಕಲ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ವಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ಅದರ್, ಮೆನ್ಸ್ಟುವಲ್ ಸೈಕಲ್. ಮೆನ್ಸ್ಟುವಲ್ ಸೈಕಲ್ನಲ್ಲಿ ದೇ ಆರ್ ಕಂಟಿನ್ಯೂಸ್ ಬ್ರೀಡರ್ಸ್ ಅಂತ ಕರಿತೀವಿ. ಈವನ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಕೇಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಈಸ್ಟರ್ ಸೈಕಲ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ, ಬಟ್ ಒಂದು ವರ್ಷದಲ್ಲಿ, ಇನ್ ಒನ್ ಇಯರ್ ಅಟ್ ಎ ಪರ್ಟಿಕ್ಯುಲರ್ ಸೀಸನ್ ದೇ ಬ್ರೀಡ್, ಬಟ್ ದಟ್ ಡಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಮೀನ್ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ದೇ ಬ್ರೀಡ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಒನ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ದೇರ್ ಲೈಫ್ ಟೈಮ್. It is not a implication that they will be breeding only once in their life cycle. They breed every year at a particular season of the year. So especially this is what is this kind of strategy many times during their lifetime. Some produce large number of the offspring. Number is large, right? Large number of the small sized offspring, like it can be mosquitoes irbodu alwa, oyster fish irbodu, pelagic fishes irbodu. So all these, they produce large number of individuals. Even the frogs irbodu, usually the aquatic organisms, usually the organisms which follow the external fertilization or the egg laying organisms, they produce large number of offspring. So in order to compensate the loss of the organisms there. So this is one case. Others may produce small number of organisms but huge in size, like that of the elephant. Elephant, have you seen elephants producing many number? 10 elephants one day produce agudilla. Or you have not seen the cows getting reproduced 10 at once, right? Only one will be produced at once. That is a small number but large sized offspring, some birds as well as some mammals, right? Now, so which of these strategies can be the most desirable and which will help for maximized fitness? Yavudu idralli best anta helidre? See, you cannot say this is the best for any specifically. Yavudu ondu specific kind of yavudu reproductive strategy best anta helikagodilla, because see, ecologists, they suggest that life history of different organisms depends upon the various biotic and abiotic factors which it comes in interaction with, and also it will, so many constraints irutte, so tumba checkpoints irutte. In order to cope up with all of that, organisms, they adapt to different strategies of reproduction which is best suited for themselves. So that is why we cannot come to a conclusion that this is the best mode of reproduction for this one, right? So that is why, and there is so much research going on, so about this particular life history of different living organisms, especially with the mode of reproduction, right? So in the next class we will talk about population interactions. In the next class we will talk about population interactions. Thank you.